All right, James, we have an app we want to build to help team morale, and we want you to build it. Sure. Yeah, sounds cool. What all does the app need to do? Yeah, so it should be super simple. We'll have a database. We'll have users. We'll have a form for people to give kudos to another person and celebrate their success. We'll have a leaderboard of all these kudos, and we'll add in notifications in Discord to make it really, really cool. Cool. Okay. Well, let's do 3, 2, 1, and then we'll both say how long we think this will take. 3, 2, 1, 3 weeks.
2 hours.
No, seriously, you have 2 hours. What's up, everyone? My name is James Q. Quick, and I do weekly videos about web development related topics. And I'm here to tell you that writing code is not all it's cracked up to be. That's not really the point. My point is that sometimes you don't have to write code. You can leverage tools like low-code and no-code tools to build applications that your company or you personally want to build and do it in a much quicker time frame. So in this video, I'm going to introduce you to Buddybase, the sponsor of this video. Buddybase is a really awesome no-code, low-code tool. It actually has code built in that we'll see. It's open source. You can deploy it and run it on Docker, Kubernetes, DigitalOcean, or they even have a hosted cloud for you to host it on their platform as well. These apps are performant. They look great on mobile and desktop. They have automations, which are really cool, that you can trigger different events. And you can also connect to outside databases like SQL databases, MongoDB, and their own internal Buddybase DB. So you kind of have everything there that you need to build pretty cool and powerful applications. So in this video, we're going to build a utility app for a company where we allow users, employees, to give other employees kudos to celebrate their success. As we said in the intro, we'll have a record of all these. We'll show a leaderboard on the page, and then we'll have Discord notifications go out to a Discord server so that people see real time when these notifications are going in. So all of that said, let's go and check out today's sponsor, which is Buddybase, and build this application in about 10 to 15 minutes. All right, so I've got up buddybase.com. You'll have a link to this in the description below for you to follow along and do the same thing. But I'm gonna go ahead and sign in, and I've already got an account that I created with my Google account, with my regular Google account, and then I did one with my james@compressedfm.com email so I can have two different accounts to show you how this works. So I'm gonna go into Buddybase here, and then we'll start to look at the different applications that we have. So I've got three different ones here that are from testing, as you can imagine. They've got some quick start templates that you can look at. So if you want to see some really powerful things that are already built and explore those, you can look at those. But we're going to start from scratch and build this thing out ourselves. So let's go into create app. We'll call this James's, we'll call it James Kudos. You can kind of name it arbitrarily, whatever you want. And the first thing we're going to do is work with our data. And in this case, we're going to use Buddybase DB, which is kind of built into the platform. You could also connect to Postgres or Mongo or MySQL or all these different types of databases. It's up to you, whatever you want to use to store your data. But we'll just do the Buddybase DB here. And then we'll start with a table called Kudo. And then we'll take all these defaults here. Go ahead and create this. You could upload documents via CSV file if you have that. In this case, we're just starting from scratch. All right, so we'll go ahead and create our columns. The first is description, which will be a piece of text. This is what people are going to be appreciating about the other person. Then we'll have another column, which will be points. This will just kind of default to one, but in case we wanted a multiplier or something to say, these are going to be worth more at a certain point. This will be a number value, and we'll say that it is required. We could have min and max, so we could say min is 1 and max is 50 or something. You could do whatever you want. So we'll have those two columns, and then we need two more relationship columns. So this is a relationship with the users of who's receiving the kudos and who's giving them. That way we can also display that information. So if we look inside of our users table, this comes by default here with us in the users table. And see, we have the james.q.quick@gmail.com. We have James Quick, role admin, etc. One thing we need to do to be able to work with this is go into the Buddybase settings. So back in that icon, we'll go into our users. And I actually have two users that are in here, the james@compressedfm. But you have the ability to control which users have access to what actual applications. So I'm going to click on the james@compressedfm user and come down and choose which apps it should have access to. So I'm going to add the James Kudos app as one that this user should have access to, and it'll be just a basic user, not an admin. So we'll update that role. Now that user is available to us in this application. So let's go back to our app. Let's go into James Kudos. go back into the data tab under users. And now we should see that we have both of our users that we want to work with. This way we can test giving and receiving from two different people. All right, so then in our kudos, now we want to build this relationship. So let's say that we're going to have a receiver. This is going to be a relationship with the user table, so users. And then what kind of relationship is this going to be? Well, we're going to say that a kudo can have one user, but a user can have many kudos. So we'll say one kudo row to many, or excuse me, one user to many kudos. This is always tricky. And in this case, we'll call this property on the users table, the received kudos. All right, so we'll say the receiver in the kudo table will have a relationship to the users table on the column name of received kudos. We'll see that here in a second. So there's that one. And then we'll do the same thing, but for the giver. So we'll say giver is going to be a relationship to the users table. And we'll say one user will have many kudos, and we'll call this given kudos. This way we can track how many has a user received and how many have they given. So we'll go ahead and save that column. And now that's all the data that we actually need in here. And we'll see how to actually add this data here in a second. So to do that, we're going to go into our design. So to do that, we're going to go into our design and we're going to add a screen. So we're going to start over here. And the cool thing is they will kind of give you some stubbed out values for your screens based on your data model. So if we look at auto-generated screens for Kudo, if we go ahead and add this, now we've got our basic CRUD functionality. You see, we have a form here for creating new kudos, which is great. That's really what we need. And then we've got slash kudo slash ID. This would be to view an individual one, which we won't really use. And then we have a slash kudo, which will be kind of the home listing of the kudos. So let's go into this form. We actually want to change this a little bit. So let's click on our form, click on the form itself. And then on the right, now you can see the settings and things associated with that form. And actually we want the field group because we want to come in and customize which one of these properties is showing. So we'll say update form fields, and then inside of here, I'm going to get rid of points. I'm just going to hit the delete key there, delete that component, and then get rid of the giver. So we want to take whoever the logged in user is and have that be the giver, and they can choose who the receiver is, and then we'll give a default value for points of 1. So we'll save that. That's our new form, or actually we'll just kind of leave it there. That's our new form. And then we can go into our save button. So if we look over here on the left, we have our save button, and we can define the actions. So it's got validation here that we can do. Then we have a save form and we can actually trigger this or customize this to add the columns that we want. So we'll say that the points value, we'll say points will default to a value of 1. And then we'll add another column for the giver. So we'll scroll down and select our giver down here. And then inside of here, we can do handlebar syntax. So our double curly braces will allow us to have access to basically JavaScript variable. So we can take the current user and do dot underscore ID. So this will get the currently logged in user and use that as the giver so that we won't let them choose that. We know who it's actually coming from because it's coming from a logged in user. So let's go ahead and save this. And if we go ahead and run this, if we hit the play button in the top right, we will see we've got our James Kudos app. We couldn't find any information to display yet because we don't have any. Let's go to the Kudo page. There's the list. Let's go to create new. Let's say James did a great job. And then we'll choose the compressed FM account there because I'm logged in with my Gmail. Go ahead and save this. And now we have our record that's saved inside of here, which is pretty cool. So we have our basic CRUD functionality already kind of figured out for us. Now we need to customize this a little bit to, I want to show a leaderboard of the kudos and I want to show the accumulated points that people have gotten. So if I were to add a new one here, we could say good or great job. Again, we could choose the same person. We'll save this data. We'll come back to our kudos. You see that we have the receiver at compressed FM with 2 points. So we want to somehow accumulate all of those. And just for demo purposes, let's do another good job and let's give one to me, the Gmail account. So we'll save this. So now we have 2 for compressed and 1 for Gmail. And now we need to figure out how do we display this in a format that is showing the leaderboard of total accumulated kudos. All right, so let's go back into kudos and let's go back to our data because we're going to add a property here in our data that will actually sum up those values for the individual user. All right, so what we're going to do is in the users table, go ahead and add another column. And this column will be named total received kudos. And then we want this thing to be a formula. So this is where we can start to customize what those things are that get saved in our database. And in this case, we're going to add in a formula that's going to be a JavaScript function. Now, this is where we can add JavaScript to our application and this be a low code solution where you don't have to write code unless you want to, and you can fill in some gaps that way. So we're going to do a basic accumulator pattern here. We're going to start with a count of zero. We're going to iterate through for let of, or let kudo of. And then now we need to grab all of the received kudos. And we can do that with this syntax here, where we type in the value of the column that we're looking at. So let kudo of received kudo, so the dollar sign and then parentheses, want to get each one of those. And then we'll say count is going to be plus equals, and then we'll parse int of the kudo dot points. So for each kudo that's associated with a user that they've received, keep adding up those points, and then at the end, return count here. So this will still work even if we change the point value for an individual kudos. So let's just double check the syntax. We initialize our variable, we iterate through kudo of, and then we've got dollar sign, parentheses, quotations, received kudos, and then we add up the points for each kudo. And I think we actually named points an uppercase piece. We'll need to make sure that is valid. And then we'll go ahead and save this. And you see that this actually populated with our received kudos, which is really sweet. So now that is done, we can go back to our design and we can create a new screen in here. So we'll do a blank screen and we will call this the leaderboard. And we'll just have this be slash leaderboard. And then we'll continue. And inside of here, we're going to want a block and we'll do a table block. It's going to ask us what table we want to work with or what data. So we want to work with the users table. And then we can give a name to this. So this will be leaderboard. And then the title will be kudos leaderboard. So that should display on here. So there's our kudos leaderboard. And this looks pretty good, except for it's not super, super readable. So I don't want the role ID. I don't want the status. I don't want the received and given kudos. I just really want name, first name, last name, email, and then the total received kudos. So we can do this by filtering which columns actually get displayed. So I've clicked on the actual leaderboard itself, and then I see over here in the table section, the configure columns, and we'll just go ahead and add only the ones that we want. So we'll say first name, we'll add in last name, we'll add in the email in case people want that, and then we'll add in the total points. So total received kudos, we'll actually put that first, so it's really obvious in here. All right, so we'll save this. So we have our leaderboard. Now the last thing we want to do is actually send out notifications in Discord when this happens. So this is really cool. Discord has a thing called webhooks, and I've got open my test Discord here. If I go into my settings, there is server settings and there's integrations, and inside of here there are webhooks. I've already got one created for this Buddybase bot. It's going to make posts to the general channel, and I can copy this webhook URL. So I've already created this inside of Discord. If you'd like to know more about Discord bots, I'm working on some content, let me know in the comments below. But once I have this set up, I can come to my automations and I can add an automation. And I want to say, let's say notify Discord. Let's say when a row is created, so we'll take that as our trigger. There's lots of different triggers in here. But when a row is created, we can choose a table. So we're going to choose when a row is created in the kudos table. Now, what do we want to do? Well, let's do a Discord integration. So let's save this and then we'll go into setup and we'll say, this is the webhook URL. This is the Buddybase bot. And then what do we want this message to be? Well, we can just test this and say in handlebars or just any kind of message, just testing kudo notification. So we'll just leave that there for now. Save this. Then we can finish and test the automation. And we can do this by sending a form to the kudos table. We'll say, great job. We'll say number of points. The receiver is going to be me. The giver is compressed. And that should be good. So we can actually test this now. And I heard a notification. I don't think you heard it in the video, but the testing kudo notification came through. So what do we actually want this to be? Well, we want to notify who received the kudos and who gave the kudos. And so to do that in this workflow, we need to first query the giver and the receiver of those kudos from the kudo record, if that makes sense. So we'll go into here and we will do query rows, save that. And in this case, we want to query the user table. And then we want to filter based on the user's ID being equal to, and then this is where we can use our curly bracket syntax again, the trigger.row.receiver. So this is coming from the row that got created up here. We can access this to then search the users table for the giver or the receiver. And then we'll do the same thing. So we'll add another one of these in here for the actual receiver. So we'll go ahead and add another one of these. We will do another query row. So where's that one? We have query row right here. In this case, we'll go ahead and set it up. We'll choose the users table. We'll do another filter for the same kind of thing. We'll filter by ID. And we're going to say where it equals the trigger.row.giver. So this will be querying the giver themselves. Let's go ahead and save that. And then we'll come down to the message here and we'll update this little template. I'm going to paste in a little snippet because it's a little tricky to type out. All right, so I'm going to paste this snippet in. And I think I may have gotten these backwards before, but let's kind of break down what we're doing here. We're saying from step one, grab rows of zero. So grab the first thing that was returned, which is only one thing, and then grab the first name property, the last name property. And this should be the receiver, but I think we did these out of order. So this will actually be steps two for the receiver. And then our giver will be steps one. So we can just swap these out. And this gives us access to the values that we queried in those previous steps. So a little bit of a tedious string here, but we are able to grab all this information and display it. So let's go ahead and test this. It should send another notification. And we see that James Quick received kudos from James Ruiz Quick. So I kind of played around with my names, which is why that shows up there. But in about 15 minutes, we're able to create a really cool utility app for a business that integrates with a database. It's got CRUD operations. It integrates with Discord, which is really cool. You can integrate with Slack and email if you wanted to. And another thing I want to show you under automations is that it can integrate one with a webhook. So you can send information to this application. And then you can integrate with, if we go to row created, or let's add another step here. You can integrate with Zapier. So if you send to a Zapier webhook, Zapier can then integrate with almost anything. So a lot of power here in a no-code, low-code tool in Buddybase. Make sure to give it a shot. Let me know in the description or let me know in the comments below what you thought of it and what you like about no-code, low-code tools. Hope you enjoyed the video and I'll catch you in the next one.